Great. Finally, bringing it all together, I move to my final speaker, Ritu. Ritu is the head of Terrymo, and the question I have for Ritu, and again, this comes from a conversation we had last week, was a lot of great stuff done around employee experience fees. So my question to you, Ritu, is how will HR ensure that people working from home experience and engage with the organization and its leaders deeply enough to be able to still build a collaborative, agile, and resilient culture? And what have been some of your personal learnings in these moments that matter? Over to you, Ritu.
Indrani, thank you very much. I'm really honored today to be with you all this evening. I represent Terrymo India, founded in 1921 with corporate headquarters in Tokyo, Japan. Terrymo is a leading manufacturer of medical devices with over 20,000 associates across the world. It is a very proud moment for us as we turn into a 100-year organization next year. As my fellow panelists rightly articulated, we all are staring a new reality. Some of us are calling it the new normal. Some of us are calling it the next normal. It was very clear to us that as the world will evolve in terms of varied experiences, whether it's associate experience or whether it's customer experience, or perhaps a soon to be coined term, organizational experience, the only viable strategy is to adopt. And then go back to the drawing board to be able to unlearn, to relearn. Tsunagu in Japanese language actually means connections. Connections between organization and associates, connections that we have within our colleagues, connections between our organizations and the customers, etc. It is also the theme of our 100-year-old celebrations, which we intend to have next year. And therefore, as we ramped up our associate experience initiatives to be able to preserve the familial culture, which is founded on our core values, we brought the spirit of Tsunagu forward in anything and everything that we did for our associates. Keeping this in mind, from associate centricity standpoint, we actually looked at three pillars. Our pillar number one was associate wellness and safety. As my fellow panelists rightly articulated, apart from looking at holistic workplace optimization practices, whether it was making sure that our associates are receiving the PPEs, looking at guidelines around safety, safe workplace, etc., we also looked at making sure that how are we making our associates feel comfortable at their homes, and therefore arranging for agronomic infrastructure when the whole world was completely shut down, looking at internet reimbursements. But at the same time, I would think keeping the wellness flag forward. So we looked at launching a digital wellness program comprising of physical fitness sessions with our coach, looking at nutrition related talks. Perhaps we even invested times around having sessions on mindfulness, you know, looking at guided imagery, etc. At this point, we are also looking at exploring employee assistance programs being available to our associates as well. Our second pillar, comprised of digital associate engagement initiatives, enabling us to be able to further strengthen and retain the culture of togetherness that we had. Bringing a balance, I would think, between the classic paradox that's facing all of us today. It is the high tech and high touch, and then ultimately driving emotional connections. Under this pillar, we have looked at a series of initiatives, whether it is about launching work for home and work from home initiatives, looking at parenting tips. Some of these little elements where the intent was to informally educate our associates. That said, the idea would be to specially talk about two today. The first for us was digital bonfire. This platform happens to be an informal, interactive, engaging platform, which actually brings together all our associates every Friday for 30 minutes. The topics that get discussed are in this forum are actually very wide. we would look at celebrating birthdays, informal talent shows, having quizzes, or perhaps even look at sharing some of the key organizational messages. Some of the points that my fellow panelists brought about today, thoughts around connection, thoughts around empathy, thoughts around compassion, those are some of the innate thoughts that get discussed in this forum as well. We hold this platform very dear because we believe that those are the 30 minutes that we all come together to be able to promote, I would think, a two-way dialogue within the organization. The second initiative that I would like to talk about is virtual family days. Given the fact that the boundaries between the work and home have completely blurred, and frankly, the work culture has shifted to associates' homes. In these circumstances, we felt that it becomes even more important for us to embrace our associate families, bring them closer to our organizational social ecosystem. In that light, we created this little platform called Virtual Family Days, and we engaged with our associates' families. We tried to understand what would those moments in their lives be, what would be those moments that will matter. And most importantly, we learned about some of the great stories that our associates had, who had truly gone above and beyond their call of duty. Our pillar number three is associate learning, allowing us to pivot to the new normal. Given that Terremo India, as we stand today, is in a stage of transformation to scaled up operations, learning has always been a strategic priority for us, but in today's time, it has become even more relevant. Adapting and aligning associate skills and roles to post-pandemic ways of working will be extremely important. And therefore, to be able to advance our efforts in this direction, as a first step, our diagnosis phase enabled us to identify what would those key skills be that need to get honed so that we can quickly proceed on our rebound efforts. Our targeted approach to identify gaps was actually based on, one, engaging with our middle management within the organization, which is our people leaders, gaining their feedback. Two, looking at focus group discussions to be able to get feedback from some larger population around what are some of the skills that they feel are very important for them. Looking at and I would say engaging with our leadership team to be able to get their perspective on what those key skills would look like. Apart from this, the other pieces that we considered was that the idea was not to overwhelm people, because in the world of learning, everything becomes important today, and therefore it was very important to look at what would those skills be. So investment within the commercial skills, looking at 7 habits of highly effective people, because we would continue to be challenged to do more and more with less and less, and therefore building on and further strengthening efficiency within the organization. And lastly, maybe looking at managing virtual teams. I would think that we all are in the respective journeys to witness what the future brings forward. And I do believe that having the faith in our karma, together with a pinch of wholehearted leadership, positivity, and loads of smiles, will hopefully make us thrive. So thank you.